cannot say enough good things about Johnny, is what he calls Altec, because he talks to everyone on a first name basis.
Yeah, absolutely.
Very confusing for us when we're talking to him. But yeah, Altec, even though he says they're not even able to dual queue that much yet because of the fact that he's still in his junior year in high school, or grade 11 for you Canadians out there, like myself.
Clarifying.
Yeah, so he hasn't had as much time to dual queue as he would expect, but he's still performing at a level. Second most kills in the North American LCS for 80 carries, third overall.
And the Syndra ban actually comes out right away. Maybe a possible leave up for Yasuo or something that EG wants to play into. EG, as we've kind of heard, the inkling of that Jace pick, they definitely do a lot of homework on the teams they play. Usually a team will say, yeah, we prepare for the week, and kind of the same for each. But I think it's been a little different this season. Teams definitely need to make the extra effort.
Yeah, the individual preparation for teams changes actually a lot from week to week. Even though it feels like we're dealing with the same general pool of champions each time, the priorities change greatly. So like Twitch, for instance, is just starting to get banned. Same with Lucian, for instance. Like if Lucian's on the board,
all the way
because
to the
TSM
left,
values so much the early laning phase, they're probably going to first pick Lucian. But that actually means that EG wouldn't have to ban Lee Sin away from Amazing because Helios is a great Lee Sin, and they feel like TSM values Lucian higher than that. That's just potentially what the mind game could be going in here.
Wild Turtle has taken that Corki as a first pick, but may just want to take his AD carry as a first pick to show EG nothing. Renekton's banned out last, so they've hit mid and top lane throughout their picks. Dyrus has been the focus of some teams in the early part of the game, and they go for Amazing's Lee. Last matchup against EG, I didn't say this earlier, was his zero kill Lee Sin game. So we'll see if he can do that again.
Yeah, and immediately they then go for the Lucian because the Twitch had been banned on the other side. So they really, they forced each other into some tough decisions right there.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they both kind of get their pick of the litter in jungle and AD carry. And it's a little curious, actually, for Team Solomid to pick the one of the two junglers between Elise and Lee Sin when the other's not up, and then pass on the only AD carry. Because I guess they respect Altec's Jinx or Corki play enough.
Altec also has the chance to go for Corki, but he decides not to. Lane bully of Lucian, so he wants to get things started early. We've seen Dyrus playing Lulu as well recently. So with the bans to Dyrus, they take away a few that they can also use. Inox, not sure if we've seen him on too much Lulu. Actually, no Lulu for him, so that may be new. On the side of TSM, Shyvana for Dyrus. So very simple kind of back and forth, plain picks coming out in the beginning here. Nothing crazy.
They pick Shyvana. It opens up Inox to play almost whatever he wants. Inox can very easily pull out a Jax right here.
Yeah, he did make it through.
Also, TSM is very similar to the Yasuo composition they used at the end of last week when they run Nami, Lee Sin, and Shyvana right there. Everyone can contribute to the knockups. Only Lulu was picked away. They had the Lulu in the top lane of one of their games. His situation here, he's still on a tryout, right? It's not,
That's
he's announced.
Right.
Snoopy is still there wanting to get his next shot back. And if Evil Geniuses can't beat Team Solomid, this is the second week of Helios B here. If they can't beat Team Solomid, then they can't really consider themselves in the conversation for moving out of the bottom three.
Right.
This victory is absolutely paramount for EG.
There's definitely been a change in EG's play. But it can't really be said that it's for the better so
not
far.
Not in victories.
Right, not in victories. And it's the Yasuo and the Corki getting locked in. They have three possible help out knockups in Yasuo's own.
Yep. Bjergsen's Yasuo can be a scary beast, but how good is Pobelter against it in the mid lane? There's a chance they could keep that Lulu top if they really want to, let Poebelter go with something else in the mid lane. Inox has a lot of champion diversity. They just have to decide whether they want a Lulu against the Windwalls or do something else. Krupa doing the talking.
It's quite a safe game to play on that one. Like you said, the Jax made it through as well. Inox can get a carry if he wants to. Solid pickup for Inox. He gets back into the game. He wants to play with the Jax, and Poebelter gets the Lulu. A safe matchup versus Yasuo. You're at least staying alive for most of the time.
Yeah. This was a really well-played pick-and-ban phase by both teams. You could tell they both actually had a lot of counterplay, trading priority picks between one another. I gotta say, the planning of EG lately has been much improved, and the pick-ban preparation from Loco Doco has also been very well informed. So like, this was a really solid pick ban phase.
Very good coming in for Team Solo mid. See what happens once they get a hold in the game, if they can. Have a team that is kind of melee focus based. So if they can't get to the turrets in enough space, it's just going to be Wild Turtle trying to be Corki there. We'll see if that puts up any trouble. Right now, it's time to put your predictive powers to test. As usual, we're going over to LOLESports.com. And according to the votes, 79% of you say that Team Solo mid are going to be winning this one. I think I had that in mind as well.
Well, we mentioned last game that was going to be the 90% plus votes often backfire and ended up backfiring again. But if you start to second guess this 79% pick, you can change your vote by setting hashtag TSMWin or hashtag EGWin to the at LOL Esports Twitter account. We'll get that updated live throughout the game as it develops. It's very easy to pick those right on Twitter because you just wait until one team pulls really far ahead and you're like, hashtag,
boom,
that team win.
Like we said, you never have to tell your friends. Mm-hmm. I have all correct votes.
74-0 this year.
74-0, yeah. That's right.
Don't even know how many games we played.
Yeah, that was a good guess.
Yeah,
I wasn't going to say it, but you took the chance. So now as we're coming into game two here in week five, day two, it's kind of hard to believe we're that far in.
Yeah.
This has been flying pretty fast.
After next week, we'll be at the halfway point of the LCS regular season.
That's
split.
Crazy. And that settles into teams as well. They kind of think like, well, the first half didn't go so as well. We actually need to buck up and do some big things here because time is getting short, and a lot of these teams don't have much time. We're going to see how long this one goes. It was a 50-minute matchup last time with the first inhibitor going down at 38 minutes, a real long haul. Who's got the fight prowess to take this one to the end? TSM versus Evil Geniuses, and they're on the Rift.
And speaking of long games, TSM, because they were so out of sorts strategically at the start of the split, still have the longest average game time of teams in the North American LCS, which is completely different than the Team Solo mid we saw in the 2013 season. Those guys often played the fastest of every team.
That just means they like to play video games.
They just want to play more.
Absolutely.
Can you get it?
Bite it!
Yeah!
Yeah! Take the twin bite first. Take a bite out of crime there. Kill and vision for Inox. Amazing. Just outside of ward. Be safe though. Probably saw that go down. So a very simple line of scrimmage as usual until the teams decide which side of the jungle they're going to waltz into. Looks like we're going to lane swap here as well.
I learned some very interesting things the other day about wards.
Well, teach me.
Okay. I didn't know previously when wards are placed down, the color of the circle above the ward tells you exactly what type of ward it is. So green wards have a green circle above them. Trinket wards have a yellow circle above them. So the instant it's placed, is doing this. I told this fact to Krepo and he just one-upped me. He said if you click on the ward immediately and then look at the little icon in the top left of it, it will tell you the source of the person who placed the ward.
And why is that important?
So if you see if you see someone place a ward from Fog of War, if you click on it fast enough, you know whose trinket ward is down.
Right.
Therefore, you know who placed the ward and who's in that brush.
Overpowered.
Things these pros are doing nowadays.
Now that you told Riot, they're going to fix it.
Okay.
But no, that then you can tell. You'd be like, oh, that's not the top laners. The jungle is right here, actually. Good knowledge. Learning 101. 2 minutes into this, it doesn't look like anybody's used that to get themselves a kill in this game, but we'll keep an eye on it. Amazing's going to get some help on his red buff. Heading down to the bottom. The 2v9s, actually, Dyrus right to the lane in the beginning instead of getting this whole jungle buddy system. So we'll see how this works for him. Interesting.
Yeah, very interesting choice. Right here. Dyrus trying to survive a little bit. I feel like he's just going to get denied off the wave really early by Altec and Krepo. This is more so for Amazing to become powerful early and probably throw some early ganks in for Bjergsen. They're throwing Dyrus to the wolves.
Well, he got one CS before he went out. Not a total loss, but yeah, they definitely threw him to the wolves. Good call.
Didn't mean to do that.
Didn't mean to at all. Worked out. Just kind of falling into place. So we'll see. Yeah, it's free farm for the AD carries. We've heard Sneaky talk about how great this is, being able to hit that first item threshold, but who's going to be able to use it? And this is interesting. Dyrus taking all the little guys.
Yeah, really interesting move that they're doing right here.
No experience.
Yeah, it was like a bit of a jungle share, but not really. If Dyrus gets level... No, he doesn't even get level 2 off that.
No.
So it means Amazing's a little bit farther ahead. Dyrus a little bit farther behind. Helios doing the full jungle buddy with Inox. So Amazing will be slightly stronger than Helios, which honestly, if you're scouting this particular matchup and you've seen Helios's game since he's joined the NALCS, he is just always up in the other jungler stuff and he wants to fight almost all the time. So making Amazing a little bit stronger than him will be able to maybe punish Helios when coming in, because if Amazing can get that minuscule level difference because he didn't share with Dyrus in the start, it could very well make the difference in a 1v1 in the jungle.
Very good ward here from TSM would thwart anything Helios would try to provide in pressure for that bottom lane, but here comes the invade now. The buddy system. Oh, wait. No, the early dragon is viewed. We'll see if the pressure can be created to push them off. Doesn't look like TSM will have to juggle.
Helios stopped this the other day. It's a potential 3v5, and they're peeling for a fight. Amazing, still really strong, level 3.
Very great plays. He safeguards to the ward, making sure Inox is actually pinched into the fight. This is big damage. Turtle kind of Valkyrie's in, tries the rest of it. That's the refresh on Amazing buff. Right there, 1-0, his first blood comes out.
First pick for TSM was Lee Sin, and first blood goes to the same person. Amazing has been the person who struggles when he doesn't have his core champions, but when he's on point and he has his Lee Sin, he is threatening as hell, and that was a great move by TSM.
TSM fully aware of what's going on. Pobalter really didn't even get a chance to leave lane, and Bjergsen was already heading for the kills. TSM a step ahead, and it shows now with a 1,000 gold lead.
Yeah, the one thing about that is it gives Altec some free farm time in the top. You don't often have a team devote 5 people to the dragon
tank,
but that was because there was a team fight.
Ooh. Oh, Amazing taking the Lee Syndrome. Should be okay on this one. He'll take a few extra hits as the back door comes in. He's all right, though. 1-0. This is EG now thinking how they can repair that. Put a Band-Aid on it and make sure it doesn't happen again. Crepo's heading towards the top side. They really want to put pressure on Dyrus. Somewhere they can usually, or teams, I should say, can usually get a kill. Dyrus will put himself in that scary situation and go down before 6.
Yeah, so the 1,000 gold lead because of the dragon and the first blood kill. Really key, and you can see with the item build of Amazing as well, going with 2 long swords instead of completing his Spirit Stone, he's definitely planning on staying as aggressive as possible.
Trying to get some harass on. It looks like they're trying to take down the turret or at least get it damaged quite quick so they can leave that lane and put some pressure somewhere else if anything else goes wrong. But the pressure, it looks like it's going to be here for now. And EG looks to switch lane after maybe.
This is a big investment actually right now. Yes, they will probably want to switch lanes with Altec's first buy, but the time that Wild Turtle is getting in the bottom lane without Inox there is incredibly potent for the overall experience level of this game. 4 people in the top lane for EG against 2. If they do not make something happen, it is a huge opportunity wasted. And TSM is playing very conservatively. It looks like this is just a waste of time for me.
They're really well read, especially Amazing heading into the jungle, seeming like he's safe, getting some wards down. They have to realize we have zero vision of a majority of EG's members. Something crazy is going on right now. And you can see Dyrus, he doesn't usually do that. He's having fun with it.
Yeah, they're just going to 4-man push this turret now to try and make the best of a bad situation.
So EG's finally going to be able to get this top turret. I've actually been pressuring it for quite a few minutes. It's going to go down and put that pressure somewhere else. And let as many minions get denied as possible here. And Glebe will help to soak up.
All the while, Amazing was getting ward control in the red buff area of EG. So they're looking for a steal at that point. They're planning one step ahead, right? It's very important to have ward control behind where you want to go next, just so you know when you are going to be collapsed upon. And right now, because ED spent so long in that brush, they have no plans laid out for the future.
Should be an alive Dyrus, as not too much can happen. We see TSM's wards hopefully planning for their future. Bjergsen picking up wraiths, 52-46 on Pobelter, who isn't having an amazing game for himself, but without Bjergsen getting anything on that last dragon, he's still fending for kind of even in the mid lane.
And they're still just jungling with Inox, which means Turtle is farming quite well. TSM is good at this 2v1/2v0 game. We saw right there, they really brought the next adaptation to the early dragons. They committed enough people to the early dragon and juggled it well enough that they weren't low, and then were very ready to turn when Helios showed up, because Helios did that against Complexity yesterday and pushed Complexity clean off the dragon. They tried it again today, and TSM was ready to punish it. So that shows good preparation by Lokodoko, their coach, and the rest of the team.
Really solidifies TSM always being around the mid, always being around their objectives. Easy to flow to each side of the map when necessary. Right now they're on the top side. Anigis denying more, clearing wards. It looks like they're going to get a pinch onto Altec and Krepo here. Altec came out very big in a similar situation yesterday, but this looks grim.
Yep, well, they lost control of their red jungle. Helios now knows it's been gone, which means the alert should be on for Altec and Krepo. They should know Lee Sin is in the proximity. In the area.
It looks like they're actually going to halt that one. 2 minutes on to Dragon. They actually did not know where Helios was, and they didn't want to get countered themselves. So TSM, while knowing they have a little bit of a lead, are still taking things quite careful. Going to go ahead and actually clear that up. No reason for Blue to go anywhere else. It's not really a mana-dependent team anywhere around the map. We're going to have a turret falling. First one of the game, 9 minutes in the top lane. So we're going to get a switch up here and might get the standard matchup in the bot now.
Yeah, AD carry is pretty even on farm when we consider BF Sword, Vamp Scepter completed for Altec. He is actually 100 gold behind Turtle, so Turtle can get pretty much the exact same items when he goes back to base, which he's doing right now. Spend all that sweet cash.
This will be good as well. Everybody will be buffed up and itemed up for their 1 minute till Dragon. We'll have the new items for the AD carries. Nobody's really able to capitalize on a finalized item, just the pieces of Bloodthirster. Even in the mid lane, Bjergsen is not ready to piece together a finalized item. So their first fight's going to be really big on who can get the first catch. Right now, TSM, it's like they would be the one to initiate that.
Right.
They know they have EG.
And they're pretty strong with Amazing at level 6 right now. And they've also called EG on their next rotation.
Ooh.
EG got the deep wards into the jungle here, but TSM is ready to take their own stuff back. Meaning the deep wards are not that effective for EG, whereas when TSM plays deep wards in the red jungle of EG, they're able to come away with the red buff.
Already bringing out the pink ward play. Like you can see, as you said, that horseshoe of red wards from EG placed in the bottom side of the map. But will they be able to have the pressure on Dragon? Right now, pink warded out above and below, and Amazing is just pretty much able to single-handedly stop this from happening.
Yeah, this Dragon fight is huge. Consider that Amazing also has a Spirit of the Elder Lizard, which is an incredibly important power spike for junglers. That's why many junglers, including Meteos, will not share jungle farm until he has that item. It is such a power spike for Lee Sin. And now TSM wants that second Dragon. With the ultimate down on Dyrus, if Inox went back to base and came in for the fight, maybe they could have an edge, but he would be forfeiting his turret. So TSM has a lot of capital to play with right now.
Definitely a change in playstyle for Team Solo Mid. A long time ago, a team that would let a few dragons go to gain a ton of the map. But right now, grabbing this, they know they can take EG and then the map. Very aggressive playstyle that they're putting back into play.
Bjergsen
back on the assassins, kicked away. Pole Belter gets a flash in to put himself on the right side.
Yep, that was the combo. That's why you run Lee Sin jungle with Yasuo. You go to kick him in the air and immediately follow. But Pole Belter saw it coming, flashed away.
Helios doesn't really have anywhere to go. Bjergsen flashes over the wall as he predicts the escape and gets the kill.
Now is the jungle power struggle actually going right back to Amazing. He previously landed one nice Sonic Wave to get Helios to that point of low health.
Right.
And obviously Bjergsen still had his flash because he didn't go all in on Pobelter. Really nice play by Amazing. His Lee Sin is threatening. I don't think EG expected them to first pick that Lee Sin, quite honestly. I think they expected the Lucian to be first picked. And Amazing is showing you why his Lee Sin is so feared, quite honestly.
Coming out very strong. Either jungler deciding to really hit up a Sightstone early in this one, but TSM already has the wards that a Sightstone would provide right inside EG's jungle. So they're doing quite well for themselves, 12 minutes in the game. A 3,000 gold lead. It seems like everybody's finding a way to make a lot of money in the early game today.
Yeah, this is a really disappointing start for EG after their great victory over Complexity. And there's kind of the ongoing question of how good is EG really when you look at kind of what happened today with Complexity's big win over Dig. And when you consider TSM's the team that lost to Dig yesterday. So you thought if this matchup clashes up right now, it's going to be really close. But just based on the start, TSM really has prepared well.
It was very close the last time these two teams played, but a different story here. Amazing making sure of that happening. And even the simple things to be pressured now. Blue buff for EG is going to be contested. Amazing just on the outside.
He's
they aren't even going to go in on that one. EG's going to, or rather TSM's going to have mid turret. Nice control over that. And Inox is kind of pressuring out Dyrus here. So with a bit of a gain here for Team Solo Mid, we're seeing that Dyrus is early. Transition to the lane in the beginning and then back to Amazing. Hasn't hurt him too bad. And he's able to keep up quite well.
Yeah, does burn his flash, so they're scrapping up there. But his heavy armor build is keeping him
to be able to teleport
savvy.
Back up.
Yeah.
Ooh.
This is just constant invade pressure by TSM. If they can't get either of these buffs, it'll mean EG's actually coming back a little bit in this game. But if EG can't defend this one, it'll be TSM continually pulling ahead.
Well, it looks like they've turned bot lane into mid lane now. Pobalter and Bjergsen are having it out with the two turrets that are actually still standing on the map. This red buff battle right here, TSM is not giving up.
What just happened, though, is Inox doesn't have his teleport up. Dyrus went back to base and teleported in, meaning TSM could have an advantage in there if Dyrus comes and gets it. Or they're just going to take the lane advantage while EG is grouping up trying to defend against Amazing, and that's actually the option that TSM's going for.
They have to know that Inox is close with the pressure that Dyrus is putting on, and they're still contesting that red buff. They stay, but nothing actually comes of it. Helios does come away with the red buff. And this turret in the top lane will be going down for Team Solo Mid. It takes a few more minions. 2-1 in turrets, a bit more of a gold lead coming in for TSM, but they're not really pressuring their lead too much. They're just taking it as it comes.
Yeah, a good patient style of play from them, because it's not like they're holding on to this minuscule little gold lead. They're extending it by leaps and bounds by taking the right options. 4,000 gold at 14 minutes is nothing to joke about. It is a substantial lead. And it gives them item breakpoints in almost every roll when they decide to shop.
We're getting into that point as well. Well, I guess that point, but Altec's going to be able to get into some team fights. We don't exactly have late game jacks from Inox just yet, so the fights aren't totally in EG's favor, but it's where we see Inox get a huge influx, or Altec rather, get an influx of gold and start to become a carry for the team. Pobelter's had a bit of a slow game as well. Someone that EG looks to really get on the shoulders of, and he's not been able to do much for the team. But that's also TSM kind of, like you said, playing slower than they usually do.
Ooh. Yeah, but TSM is right on point this game. Bjergsen is farming really, really well, which is incredibly dangerous for this EG team when you consider how well the composition is built around Yasuo to be able to ult the targets he really needs to get to.
Good play by Inox. Out of mana, though, this could be a big fight if that's a Dragon Descent from Dyrus. He decides to back off on that.
Dyrus knows his limits. He knew Inox was out of mana so that he couldn't actually all in him. And he was just getting as much farm and applying as much map pressure as he could. Look at how deep into territory that is. There's the combo, but again, Bjergsen actually couldn't ult off of it.
Makes it on his way down. They're just inches away from being able to activate any of these. He hits up Pobelter, but could have been stopped right up by Krepo and the rest of the team with crowd control. TSM applying pressure on the bottom lane. Dyrus actually stays top to not allow Inox to go near. Not like he would without mana, but really applying the pressure for the rest of the team.
Yeah, he wants to be able to force a teleport from Inox instead of letting him walk back to lane. Cool.
So TSM around the horn takes the outer three. You see Bjergsen with the rest of the team. And once he got down there, EG definitely had second thoughts. Huge damage from Wild Turtle. And it's not even a Sheen finish there. That was just Phage Bloodthirster with a rocket.
Yeah, the Foss Bomb on Corki really does hurt.
Yeah.
It's a nice steal by Amazing on the Wraith as well. So TSM taking all the little scraps out of the jungle and not really leaving him with anything.
Very good mind games the Team Solo Mid continues and usually knows the play once they do get that lead. Amazing making sure, like you said, do the little things. Bjergsen will be off in a lane, 1v1ing or 2v1ing as of late on the Yasuo. We'll see if we can get a 3v1 out of this game. Blocking out a little bit of Glitter Lance on that. Looks like they'll be safe to continue pushing. He actually gets help from Amazing this time, so they're doing way more of a buddy system than just allowing Bjergsen to be by himself and split push.
Yeah, and I mean, Amazing continues his pressure in the jungle.
He hits it, he takes it. The Lee Syndrome is real this game. No doctor needed. 3-0 at 17 minutes into the game. A 6,000 gold lead as TSM puts their foot down here. Doesn't look like EG is going to have much to work with.
I feel like this is the TSM fans expected when they got Amazing and Glebe into the team from here, because Amazing is taking his Lee Sin kind of to the next level here, where he is supportive in the sense that he's only got 50 CS, but he is everywhere on the map, and he is enabling Bjergsen to kind of reach new heights right there. Amazing invades, allowing Bjergsen to try to do his work, but finally a retaliation.
Oh, 2v1, here it comes, not going to be enough. A wild go from Polar, the heal from Glebe. Wait a minute, oh, there it is, the help picks onto Bjergsen, takes him down. This is actually going to be a very good fight for EG. One more Glitter Lance on Polar, enough to close it out, but it's the Helios execute as he comes in. And they turned a few kills there, but it's still 5k behind.
Whoopsie-daisy, the curse of the caster. As soon as I say how good Amazing and Bjergsen are doing, they throw away a big lead in the bottom lane by overcommitting to a fight. They had just pushed Helios off of the blue buff, so where else is he going to go but that lane? Bjergsen overcommits, gets killed, and then almost turning it around, he kind of baits his team into a little bit of trouble. So Bjergsen says he can turn, lands a nice knockup, but then honestly, it seemed like a nice try for a counter and just was not enough.
TSM getting themselves into a sticky situation there. A little room to work with, though. You can see they still want to be in the face here of Evil Geniuses. A little pressure everywhere. Whoa. Right in the face. All the way. Right up the nose. Gosh. TSM coming up big. Helios. I thought he was going to be able to at least get to one of the blue minions and get a flash on that, but everything is down for him. EG is using summoner spells and everything they can, but it's all in safety. Nothing's in the aggression form.
What a move by Turtle there to Valk over to get flank position on Pobelter. He knew the Pobelter had burned everything in the previous fight against Bjergsen, so that was a very difficult move for EG to retaliate on. But it takes a lot of confidence to pull the trigger on a move like that. You are very much trained as an AD carry. Don't Valk in over walls to initiate fights. But Turtle does that occasionally and works.
Do it. When you got such a hard shell, you can go in on things like that. Let's see it one more time.
Yeah, I mean, they had good ward control, so they knew it was
good. Look, head tuck. You're in.
Damn. Just huge damage. Helios did smite amongst all that, so yep. Blue buff wasn't stolen.
Up to the top lane, Inox to clear out a little bit. EG has a little bit of breathing room, but they need to do something with it. Right now, push back quite hard. 6,000 gold. See pings going over towards their red buff. They're saying, we need to clear this and at least get vision of our jungle. They're afraid to get out past here. Kepo clears that out, and EG starts to set up for the next TSM push. Bjergsen's at 2-item threshold, as well as Wild Turtle, and you're only looking at Alltech Bloodthirster right now. Sure, he's got some money to spend.
Yeah.
He's going back right now.
Alltech not having the kill number he was hoping for. He had double-digit kills yesterday, the second double-digit kill game he'd actually had to split. But this game, even though him and Kepo have been playing very well 2v2, TSM didn't give it to him. TSM was all about just making map movements and isolated 2v1 scenarios, which surprisingly, at the end of last split, was one of TSM's major weaknesses. They were really bad at playing that game.
Yeah.
They've definitely improved on that weakness.
EG, it seems like when they get an advantage in the game, it would be a mistake. When they won against Cloud9, that was a mistake from Complexity now. EG, still
EG
winning.
Gets an advantage
yes,
in the
when
game,
they get the advantage, they kind of lose it at the end. They get to the goal line, and then they can't continue to go in for their win. I was thinking about their win against Cloud9. Yeah.
Interesting thing about this one, EG, though,
right,
is that they didn't even get the start that they wanted. In the three games Helios had played prior, they'd always been up early game. This is the first game where a team has actually outmoved them early on since Helios joined.
Remember that Alltech play in Crepo yesterday? It was because they came in and they were able to turn that around. Have they found a lot of those? Not so much.
Yeah.
It's very hard for EG to initiate that first gold lead for themselves, that first real objective pressure. Ooh, Dyrus is going to be safe. Still creating pressure on the bottom lane to Pobelter. We're going to see TSM now trying to kind of just do a dance dictate here. Can we get EG in the wrong spot so we can push a turret? I was talking a little bit about this earlier. Wild Turtle is really the only one that can hit shots onto that turret if the team gets there.
TSM is looking back on form to kind of the TSM that was good in the spring split of 2014 with Bjergsen, but with Odd1 as well, and X-Special. It's really been this strange progression for TSM because they made so much change during the offseason. And then when you look back to the TSM of 2013 or even the spring split 2013 team, pretty much everyone is different aside from Dyrus.
Right.
And people are kind of saying, you can't just keep taking good mechanical players and expect to throw them on a team together and have it work.
Right.
Bjergsen, great mechanical man, amazing. Great Lee Sin, but where's his, you know, strategic sense and all that? And it was going to take time to come together. Whether it's there or not is still up for debate because this is one game against TG, but mm-hmm. definitely adding the coaching of Loco Doco.
What?
Okay. And the playmaking ability of the rest of them, clearly, goes very well for them. Look out, Altec.
Wow, Altec not in a good position. Still a little baffled from the last Fast Finger flash play. And it looks like they'll be able to do some good damage here. Pobelter not in the right spot at the right time. It is a big shield he's got for himself, though, and it's going to be able to drop Bjergsen on the other side. They turn the table here, but nobody's following Helios. A little miscommunication because Wild Turtle's coming from the backside. A bit of tunneling here from EG, and they don't get out safe. They lose Helios as well, so the one for one.
Yeah, Inox couldn't flank from the backside that time. He got cut off, and the timing of the dragon could not be worse for EG, or better if you look at it from a TSM side.
Talking a little about TSM's play style, how they've been doing things.
Yeah, really. They're playing much better as a team right now. You can very clearly see it. And obviously a lot of this has to do with Lee Sin and how it just meshes with everything TSM would want out of a jungler.
Yep.
Low farm, high pressure, help out Bjergsen carry, 262 CS, 23 minutes on Yasuo, help him set up kills, all those things that they wanted, kind of odd one, but better, is what TSM wants out of a jungler. They don't want Meteos on their team. And that's the player they're trying to create with Amazing, is just an improved version of Odd One, a better mechanical, yet still mindful player.
Trying to instill the Bay life.
There you go.
Make it happen. That kind of carefree play that TSM has always had. I say, look good on paper? Well, it's going to look good in game, because we'll make it happen. And TSM's always been one of those wheelhouse teams you can expect these strategies, solid strategies from game to game. This one, they've been working it all the way up to the front line of EG now, and it's began to slow down again. We said this last game was 50 minutes between these two teams. The TSM's clip right now, it looks like they'll finish out a little faster, but with having Pobelter on that Lulu, having the clear of Altec, it could take a little bit.
Yeah, TSM's average game time of the season still sitting at over 40 minutes,
mm-hmm.
but they do definitely seem like a different team today.
Oh!
Nice catch, though.
Amazing's kind of advantage here that he's given himself in the game. Could it make a problem for the rest of the team? It looks like they get out safely, but that's not something they can continue to push on. EG's making some good hits here.
A very nice Mikhail's Crucible from Glebe right there, as well as the Nami heal, to just barely keep Amazing alive. And then there was enough damage retaliated with Bjergsen to stop EG from catching. The fact that they could three-man catch single person to brush, not very close to backup, and still not get a kill, it's not good for EG.
Very true. Only buying themselves time here, but not gaining anything out of it. Looking at about 8,000 gold behind, and that's going to start to spread across every member of the team. TSM has already won in the lane, so if they're going to be winning single-handedly in these team fights in 1v1s, it's going to be only a matter of time for EG here. Doing what they can to clear out some wards. Only got three sweepers, and now the orb onto Altec for a bit more safety. Knowledge of the map.
The Altec is the guy who does the scrying orb even when they're winning.
Mm-hmm.
I actually really like it as a general concept for Altec to go scrying orb instead of the Sightstone ward. Not going to help them too much in this game. He'll be able to throw one scrying orb down onto Baron when TSM tries to force it, but then it'll go on cooldown and they'll be able to continue to pressure from there.
That's what this game came to last time. EG kind of forcing themselves into a necessary Baron. They were on the ropes, and they had to get something to put themselves back in the game. Dangerous things, though, especially when TSM's this far ahead. It's almost not even an option. And Amazing's already waiting. He's saying, who can I take out next? Not from there.
Yeah. Found him.
Orb use secured and found Amazing. TSM's not really worried about it, though. They make no quick movements. They're slowly walking along. Krepo almost gets himself into trouble, actually. A good back and forth between Dyrus and Inox in the bottom lane. It's been pretty even between those two.
Yeah, without a great hook from Krepo, there's really not much EG can do to completely shut down this move. Good wind wall there. Stop Helios' cocoon.
No waiting for Inox to get big. Triforce is finished. Not going to make a huge impact fighting Dyrus, but if he can get to the back line, you still have a Jax. Right now, he's getting pushed around, so TSM's getting everything they want out of this map pressure.
Yeah, I feel like Dyrus's build right now will work up to a point. I like the full tank Shyvana against Jax for the most part because he will win duels with him over extended periods of time. The time when that stops working is like 45 minutes in where Jax ignores the Shyvana damage to kill turrets. But that's not where they're at right now, so TSM has exactly what they need to deal with Nox.
That's going to be a back and possible teleport in. I don't see that coming in from Inox right now. He has low health, low mana, but EG's still trying to do what they can. Inox will be healing up
right
and try
now
to teleport in.
There it goes.
Here he is, right inside the Baron Pit on the pink ward. Pobel just getting hit up. Wild grows himself. A lot of the DPS has already been used. A full counter-strike on Team Solo mid. Will they be able to follow up with damage? TSM assesses the fight and says, let's keep going. Now onto Povelter. Wild Turtle shredding some damage from the outside. Valkyrie's into the fight once again to keep the follow going. Helios is going to be the next hit. A boss bomb and a bubble and a triple kill for Wild Turtle. They're going hard. Shells are on all members.
Seems like Turtle's out of a slump, that's for sure, because he just wrecked in that fight when Bjergsen died before it mattered. That was basically TSM winning the fight 4v5 and only having Dyrus' ult at the end of it. Really good execution by TSM after
one more
failure.
Let's
at
look
the start from Bjergsen. So look at how much Bjergsen gets thrusted down because he gets stunned and basically just blown up by the Jax and Lucian. And here, it's like, all right, is TSM going to keep going? How much confidence do they really have? And it's on mainly Wild Turtle to do this damage. Amazing's out of the fight. Dyrus is a full tank.
Yep.
It's Turtle doing all this damage. He flashes in for the kill because he knew they had the supremacy in that fight and really just cleaned up 5-0-3. And he picked up the Infinity Edge too.
Yeah. Turtle really writing off on this one, having a huge surge in gold in that fight. Not going to be contested for really anybody. He could be soloing in this game. So the rest of the team knows their strength. They go right back to Baron. No problem necessary.
If they win that fight without Bjergsen, why not just keep having it again and again?
No problem coming in from EG on this one. Almost. I thought Krepo was going up to maybe clear or get the last hits on the pink. They're going to be going for home, though. The wards are there for EG, but that only is going to tell them where TSM is coming from to take those inhibitor turrets.
Yeah, and the forever contested blue buff as well.
All game.
For EG. It just goes to show that TSM is thinking fairly well along the lines of their priorities. No longer is it the TSM that just kind of sits in lane, thinks about solo queue, and waits for someone to make a play. They're very much blue buff up, go to blue buff. A minute before blue buff is up, ward blue buff.
Yep.
And prepare for that. And as soon as they have the edge, it allows them to much more decisively cut through their priority list and make it happen.
And communication as well. We talked a little bit about how that was happening with Loco Doco and Glebe and somewhat in the early game. Bjergsen takes over now for the fights. And not that it helps a ton to have Bjergsen die, but when the call shot caller dies and you still have a lead in the fight, it's almost kind of perfect.
True.
You see everything that's going on.
You do this. You do that.
Yeah. Call it out, make it happen. And right now, that fight worked perfectly for Evil Geniuses. Bjergsen looking to stay alive in this next one, but two Infinity Edges, I think, will give them enough shock and awe to end the fight without EG knowing what happened. So much damage and DPS coming out without regards for really mitigating everything. They said Dyrus and Amazing are big enough. Full DPS. Let's go.
And I gotta say, Glebe probably builds more active items than any support in the LCS. I know a lot of supports have a lot of active items. He frequently goes Mikhail's and QSS. So in the rare case that him and Turtle are both CC'd at the same time, he can still get both of them cleared.
7 usable triggers per fight, including his abilities.
I mean, everything except his boots is an activatable item at this point.
Hey, if you're like me, then you often try to drink your boots when you're in lane. Just gotta remember to move the potions. 32 minutes on, 9-4. And still, TSM's gold lead is surging right now. 5-2 in turrets, and it's not even the mid one that's gone down. So EG's got a long way, even in the shortest lane on the map, if they start to come back. Cleared out from Wild Turtle, and the rest of the team begins to gather for the mid lane push.
Yeah, they do have that one outside turret that I think they'll probably clean up, unless they get a really clean catch elsewhere.
Ooh. That was a little dirty. It wasn't as clean as they wanted.
Yeah, that wasn't the nicest catch for TSM.
No, you don't want the big guy to kick everybody.
And Dyrus is such a mega tank right now. He could just basically ult in, and then Bjergsen could fall, and they could wreck through with the AoE damage from Turtle. matter of having the right minion wave for that.
Mid's got a pretty good push on it. The bottom lane is what they're focused on right now.
Up.
Yeah, very nice.
Complete.
Turtle in the back. They're able to do everything they can. Not even worried about being able to get to the turret from long range. And they're going to dive this one back to Helios. TSM amazing. He actually jumps over to the right to get a kick on three members of the team. They're going to start backing out. The culling is dodged there. They dance around a heck of a lot of damage coming out of EG there.
Yeah, but they get the inhibitor cleanly without suffering any right. casualties. That was actually more of an initiation to push off than it was to get kills. Because they know the Baron regen will hold them true, and they have generally low cooldown ultimates across the board.
What a
Dyrus
play.
Didn't even Shyvana ult. He still got
solo mid coming in here. Turtle.
Windwall as well.
Always having blue in this game. It's almost like a resourceless team. Bjergsen, amazing, and the rest of them can all go in. Dyrus doesn't have to wait on mana. They can keep fighting, and with Baron regening them, they are so strong right now. Another inhibitor goes down. And it's Wild Turtle on the back line. His blue buff wears off, so they're going to have to be careful how far they keep going. And it looks like they're going to take a second guess, just for a second.
With how easy those pushes were for TSM, yeah. they can do the same thing for the middle turret. They just have to wait for the minions. Or not.
No.
They're just going to go for it. That's a little aggressive. This would be EG's time to try and initiate, which is why they back away.
And they have to go on one of these. They cannot let TSM continue to walk all over the base. Pretty much lighting fires left and right. 9-4 is the game. Definitely a change from the previous time these teams have played. TSM on the up and up in their strength in the matchup versus Evil Geniuses. Just a few more turrets left on the map, chat. And it looks like TSM has them in their eyes. Just a few minutes.
Yeah, this could be the final fight. It's been slow and steady this time for TSM. Hook in for Dyrus. That could be the start of the fight.
There's a three-man tidal wave. We're going for a ride, and it's going to be Inox that tries to stay. He's swimming for his life. The floaties aren't going to work. He goes down. On the outside, Helios gets hit up. Another double kill from Wild Turtle. Can he finalize another triple? It's not going to be necessary. This looks like it's enough for TSM to take the Nexus.
Third inhibitor down and in good time as well. 34-minute win, 7-0-4 for Wild Turtle, quelling the doubts that may have arose
yep.
from the defeat to Dignitas. So a nice, clean finish for the week for TSM.
The whole team really coming out of any slump that there has been or would have been. 35 minutes into the game, Team Solo Mid takes down Evil Geniuses. Final score, 13-4.
Getting the last kill for good measure as well. 1-0-10 is the final score for Gleeb. And that was impressive for Team Solo Mid. They